Well, this is not a hand. This is just not a hand. If we had a mana dork, like if I had a Sylvan Caryatid in this hand, I'd probably snap keep, because then I can go Temple Scry for a green source and have the potential of going like Caryatid into Zenigos or something, or like finding a burn spell. And if we had a burn spell, I'd probably keep this too, because then at least I could like deal with his first threat. But really, what we actually have is nothing. So, Mullerino. This hand might be too slow. We are on the play, though. I'm going to keep this. And the Wooded Foothills is going to fetch a mountain anyway, so I'm just going to do that now. Because why not? Send it back. Yeah, the Arc Lightning might just be too slow, depending on what our opponent is up to. He attacks, sure. This is not an opponent where I just want to like block willy-nilly. And this is exactly why. I think this is Arc Lightning able. It's gonna be a 3/3. Should lose to it, God's willing, but which playing Hornet Nest would not do. Yeah, alright. Running into your card. If he uses a God's Willing here, oh, he just pumps it with a Defiant Strike. In the second Defiant Strike. Yeesh. Yeesh, I say. Yeah, maybe playing Hornet Nest was better. I don't know. I guess that's why I made the play, because I didn't know, right? Yeah, definitely just going to eat 3, drop a 13. He's going to pump, that's fine. Yeah, his deck looks solid. Hopefully I can hit a land and play this Stormwrath Dragon, and then he'll need to like double God's Willing his guy or something to get it through. Because getting it flying won't really matter. Playing the Hornet Nest earlier might have been really good, though. Courser? Does Courser do anything? Courser doesn't do anything. I'm just going to play this Hornet Nest. And hope that is better than it looks on paper. Sure hope my opponent doesn't just kill me. Yeah. So playing the Courser here gives me a better shot at hitting the Stormbreath Dragon next turn. But it also looks really bad if he like double pumps at their favorite hoplite and gets like close to kill you range. Which is why I played the Hornet Nest. Not exciting though. Not exciting at all. My opponent's fetching out. He's going to play that 3 drop. He's going to play something. A hero? Okay. That's what I wanted to see. The good ol' just passing the turn. Now I'm going to play Courser. See if I can hit this land drop. Yes. In some decks, if like all of my lands came into play untapped, playing Courser wouldn't actually help me hit, except for like the card that's under the top one. But with this deck, where there's a lot of coming to play tap lands, it's especially important to play the Courser here, so that I can play the Dragon next turn, which I think will be very important. I can play the Dragon, and I can clone it, and not die. I've got big dreams. Big dreams for not dying. And I would snap jump with Courser at this point. It's kind of already done its job. Obviously, I would love to keep it in play, gain some more life, have it accrue value, but you can't always get what you want, and staying alive is more important than anything else right now. But yeah, LA's Disciple right now gains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which is a relevant amount of life, but I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to play the Stormbreath. Be in really good shape, I think. It can get tapped down by that X spell. I'm not familiar with his list at all. I have no clue what's going on over there. But that's a card I'm kind of worried about with the tap X creatures. They don't untap during the next untap step. Card would just murder me here. So we have 4 lands. We could go clone plus Hornet Nest next turn, which seems pretty strong. If I did that, I would consider consider sending some guys in so I can start working on killing my opponent. Yeah, he just has a ton of guys and not very many enablers for them. So I guess he's a little screwed over there. But that happens. That certainly happens. What do I want to do here? I kind of like just the Disciple. Just to gain some life back up. And then I'm not sure if I should send in Storm Breath. Probably not. Yeah, I'm going to. Well, sending in Storm Breath doesn't actually increase my clock that much, does it? I hit him for 4 down to 12. And then next turn I could keep a Storm Breath back. Hit him for 4 down to 8, and then the turn after that. But like with Monster Sing Storm Breath anyway, I might as well just wait until next turn. Play the clone and the Sylvan Caryatid. Or maybe even have a land and another Hornet Nest out. I don't know. Cause it's well. I'm gonna tank. I think. Yeah. Not super confident in that attack. But I'm at 18. His largest creature is a 4/5. It's got a lot of random, like, 0/4s and 2/2s in play. My board, like, looks pretty good against random 2/2s. Okay. Resistancing. So it's getting a second threat ready. Is it protection from green? Get some scrying. That's fine. And I don't think I'm actually going to clone dragon. Just because next turn I'll be able to Monstrous Dragon anyway, assuming he has a card in his hand that'll be lethal. I think I'm just going to clone the Nylea's Disciple after I play another Caryatid. I think that's a stronger line. I could be wrong. I could be super wrong in that. But it seems fine. I'm up to 23 now. He's at 8. Yeah, he just packs it in. Okay. Yeah, so giving a guy pro green and attacking in is pretty strong when your opponent's plan. Still, like, gum up the board with Hornet Queens and stuff, but Stormbreath Dragon's really strong against what he's up to. Okay, I'm gonna take out this Chandra. I didn't like it at all. I actually liked Nylea's Disciple a decent amount. So I'm gonna bring in one of those. Even if it's just a fog, like, he's spending a lot of resources to make his creatures look good. So fogging seems strong. Arc Lightning, I think, is just way too slow. So what I'm going to do is -2 Arc Lightning, +1 Fog, +1 Negate. That's kind of interesting. Negate might be worse than another Hornet Queen, just because naturally ramping a Hornet Queen out on turn 4 seems pretty good against what he's up to. I'm going to take out a Reclamation Sage and bring in one Queen. He's got a couple targets for the Sage that might end up being relevant, but I think I think it's fine to leave it out. The only real target I can see hitting is the one that gives flying, and then you're already courting for 3, so like why aren't you courting for something else that's sweet? I'm gonna try this.